Okay, so we're gonna be starting now. Hi everybody, I hope that you are enjoying the day so far. Are you?
Yes.
Very good. So, I'm Fabrice Catala. I'm working for a company, so SI, which is Cloud. Cloud is a silver partner working essentially in the UK. And I'm a Salesforce architect working for them. I'm quite busy in the social networks. You can connect with me, on, especially on Twitter. I've got a blog, a newsletter, and I'm also a co-organizer of the Reading Developer User Group. So if some of you in the room are living in the area or working in around the Thames Valley area, we're organizing this developer meetup every first Wednesday of the month. So you're all welcome to join. It's free. We've got a free beer, free pizza, and a free talk. It's all about Salesforce. So yeah, feel free to join us. Okay. Yeah, and I'm bold as well. So we got this thing called the Bold Force. I don't know if you heard about this. Yeah, it was couple of friends in the ecosystem who are meeting and doing from time to time some charity work. So if you're interested by Bold Force, you see a couple of colleagues at the back of the room, you know where to find us. It's easy. So, take a look at our faces. Right, let's move on. Before we start, I just wanted to highlight the fact that the presentation will be available online, so there's going to be some video as well. You can, well, we can talk in the corridor afterward. And so the point is to say that, yeah, don't worry about taking notes. And I'm going to be showing some URL. Don't worry about this. You can download them afterward. Okay. Other point I'd like to raise the actual scope of this presentation. It's called Migrating to Lightning. It's not so much about Lightning, it's about migrating. Okay, so it's about the migration itself. So if you're here in the room trying to get a better understanding about Lightning, I think that now would be a good time to leave because we are not going to talk about Lightning in detail. Okay? Nobody's leaving. Very good. Next. Okay, so that's the agenda for today. So you may have, so if you are in the room, so you may have read the session abstract. Okay, so I've been implemented so Lightning for a couple of customers, a little bit more than a couple, but still there's always this question around staying classic, so for the existing customer versus moving to Lightning. For new customers, so I think that it's more of an obvious choice, easier choice at least. But yeah, when you think about all the customer base, all Salesforce customer base accumulated through so many years, of course, you've got everybody still on a classic. Some start to migrate, and that's the point of the conversation. So if you're on a classic, what is the key driver for the change to Lightning? So first of all, why would you move to Lightning? If you know and can answer this question, the next question is when? When should you move to Classic? Is it as soon as possible? Is it a delayed deployment? And then when you get to planning the migration, how do you do it? First of all, let's talk about the why. So that's going to be our agenda for today. Why, when, how. Let's talk about the why. And to stick with the London Calling theme, so I've called it should I stay or should I go? Should I stay on a classic or should I go to Lightning? And that's a balancing act. So first of all, you've got various reasons to stay on Classic. So you may have attended a session this morning about we've always done it this way. So it was a great session. You can refer to it, by the way, by accessing the slide afterward as well. So that can be just change reluctant, so people who are not necessarily keen to take the risk to move. But you've got another take on this, which is about the security or the complexity of the move, and in particular in enterprise customer, where you've got a big footprint, so quite a lot of applications running side by side on Salesforce. It can be considered as a risky choice. And from in this world, so there's this frequent way to talk about the production environment. It's definitely, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. And that's the difficulty to deal with a complicated production environment. Okay. So that's one way to look at it. On the other side, you've got some interesting side to Lightning. So I'm going to bring them little by little. So first of all, you've got the obvious benefit of Lightning, that it refreshed the look and feel. So you end up with a great modern looking user interface. Another interesting fact about Lightning is that it's mobile friendly. When you configure Lightning, you are, without realizing, configuring mobile. Okay? So if you want to deploy Salesforce One, for instance, that can be the opportunity to do it on and refresh the desktop app to Lightning. And then that could be as well, so an opportunity to review your existing business process. You may consider to take make it a project to review your existing business processes and try to map them in a new world of Lightning. Okay? So at Cloud, for instance, we are using a process mapping application, which is Element Cloud, which is great because it interfaces nicely with Salesforce. So that's something you may want to look into. Okay, so there are other arguments as well to move to Lightning. Next, and I'm going to skip through this one, sadly, because it's a massive advantage. It's a change in the way we use to configure an application, bringing on the componentization. So that's something which I'm really interested into. I think that's the future of enterprise application. And I know as well, so there's a talk about technical debt. Personally, I think that implementing Salesforce with component is sort of, by the new approach of plugging all these components together, this is a way to get rid of technical debt. And customers who are starting today on Lightning, with the use of component, will keep their application as safe as it was on day one, thanks to the use of component versus undocumented code, as we can see more and more in the field. Okay. Then there's the other point about the Salesforce strategy. Salesforce is focusing on Lightning. So I was lucky to be at Dreamforce this year, and Parker Harris at the True to the Core session and explained the fact that so they got a pool of engineers, and they got the choice to split this pool into two teams, one which keep Classic alive, and the other one which start to pushing Lightning. Problem is that it's not necessarily a good strategy, because they don't have difficulty to reach the stage where they want to be on Lightning. So they've they made a call to focus the engineering force into Lightning, into the future. Okay, so it's sending signal, I would say, about the fact that that's the strategy. If you want to move your application, business critical application, into the future, look no further. It's Lightning is definitely the choice. Okay. So, think that from my perspective, so here I'm a sort of pushing the benefit of Lightning. Still, I can understand that there may be cases where you're not there still, and Classic is the best choice for you. Okay. But yeah, you just need to, I think, weight the pros and cons, and rather than just staying in classic for the sake of taking no risk, I think it's worth the effort to take a look at Lightning and consider a migration project. Okay. So let's take us to when, and we'll say source. As you all know, there's this notion of a roadmap that we need to bring to the table. So sorry, I couldn't have a more recent diagram. So we are after winter 17, as you know, but still the idea applies. So you need to position your business requirement. What is it you want from your application on the roadmap? And to do so, you need to study the roadmap. Okay? So you cannot make a clear cut on I will stay on Classic or I will move to Lightning, or identify the best time to move. If you don't have the roadmap in view, you need to realize that some of the features are not necessarily available, and if they're not, when is it they're going to be released? So for instance, in the early days, Salesforce focused on the Sales Cloud, which means that to summarize, you could say, if you're running a Service Cloud, just a Service Cloud, it was obvious that you couldn't go to Service Cloud on the first release. Okay? But then, so they started bringing on more and more features from Service Cloud, and Spring 17 in this respect is great. So so you do need to master the roadmap. Okay. And so when you look at it, so I tried to come up with a sort of description of the capability so we've got on the platform, as well as what you've got in your own application. So I've drawn this diagram, so where I sort of list an amount of feature or capabilities. So that's the classic bit. That's Lightning, okay? And each time, so the light color show your area of interest. So you've got certainly quite a lot of, if you're in Classic, so you certainly have quite a lot of features that you're not using today, so you can forget about them. And this is your footprint, so that's the solution you're using, so in Classic. Okay? So that's taking a look from application perspective. Now, in terms of Lightning, so as we can see already, we've got a feature gap. Okay? So feature that you've got today in a Classic that are not in Lightning. Okay. But you also have new feature. Okay. So something you need to take into consideration. You cannot just focus in the negative side. You also have some improvement, and we will need to balance them later on. So if you take a look from this time, oops, sorry. So if you take a look from the business perspective, you can see this vision where you've got certainly a feature gap, but you've got as well this improvement which are brought to you by Lightning. Okay? So we're going to focus on the feature gap and the improvement. And that's taking us back a few slides back. Sorry about this. Okay, we're back on track. Right, so that's the legwork, I would say. That's what you need to do to analyze, so first of all, the feature gap, and then take into consideration the improvement. So feature gap, first of all, you got several several cases, I would say. The first one, you've got a clear identify capability, so like forecasting, for instance, but you do know is supposed to be released, so in this case, in the Spring 17. Okay, so you can plan, so if forecasting is a part of your solution, you need to, at least wait for Spring 17 to consider moving to Lightning. Then you've got another case, which is the case of documents, for instance, which are officially stated as will not move to Lightning. So in this case, you need to try to map out with a plan B. So in this case, you need to research file, will file do the trick and help you out to overcome the difficulty here. You also have some feature which are plan, but with no date. Okay. So at least you know that it's a plan indeed. So it's a question of waiting until you've got more information about this. But unfortunately, you cannot communicate around the date for the migration. Okay. One way to do it as well is to segment the rollout. If you are forcing yourself to move to Lightning for specific reasons, so for instance, some of your users are really waiting on specific improvement, you can say, okay, I'm going to move even a specific application or a specific segment of user to Lightning. And for instance, the account manager will stay in Classic. So that's a way to consider it. Okay. I recommend not to do what I would call a partial rollout, where you would deploy Lightning and enable let the user come in and come back to Classic. Okay. So that's counterproductive, and that's not a good way forward, in my opinion. So another point you can see, another case, is what I call the annoyances. Excuse my pronunciation. For which there's no clear communication. In this case, what I recommend is for you to go to the IDEA Exchange, submit a request, clearly document your use case, and make sure that you reach the product management team, especially in advertising. So if you're on Twitter, for instance, you may want to communicate around your idea and try to gather as many people to vote for your idea. Okay? And we'll see an example in a next slide. And so as I said, so you got as well some interesting improvements. So I have just a couple here. So first one is the sales path, for instance, which is already available. And then again, so you've got the same situation where you've got an announcement, so on a roadmap, you know that for a specific release, you're going to have a specific feature released. So let's take a look at what I call an annoyance. Okay, so you may remember this little snowman. So see, this lady took it to ID Exchange, as I mentioned, and she's got quite a few activity on this lightning speed. ID Exchange, and she's got a response from Phil Calvin, so EVP Engineering from Salesforce, which explained basically that they're aware of the situation, that they're working on the topic, and in a multiple way. So there's a really clear communication around what your user potentially feel, and that is not necessarily communicated by the by Salesforce. So try to trigger this. Their reaction. Okay. So I was talking earlier about listing identifying the feature gap, basically. And the good thing about Lightning is that there's quite a lot of documentation available. So when I did this research, in fact, I discovered information that I could have used earlier. So for instance, you got a list of what's not available in Lightning. So that's a fantastic piece of documentation. You've got quite a few sections, and when you click on a link, you're going to drill down into the features that are potentially a feature gap for you. So that's, I think, a fantastic documentation, very helpful. Then you've got something else that I think, from my experience, is pretty rare in a Salesforce world, is a clear communication around the expected delivery date. That's something that Salesforce always step back to overcommit in terms of when is it we're going to release this feature, hence the safe harbor statement. the case of Lightning, they are really committing themselves, and you've got this version, so HTML version, and you've got a PDF as well, which is slightly different, which is very interesting. See, they're talking about features with a specific date, and then, see, even 2018, when is it that you're going to get edit filter dashboard? Oh, 2018. So since spring, since spring 2017, we've got this new feature, which is the Lightning Experience Readiness Report. That's a very clever thing that they've done. Basically, so you navigate through the setup and you get Salesforce to run through your org, try to figure out what's in use, what's not in use. They can also detect the sort of browser you're using. So if there's some incompatibility between the browser that JoeBlog is using, they're going to tell you, as part of this email we're going to send you, JoeBlog is using a browser which is not supported by Lightning. You may want to upgrade or change the browser. Okay? But I mean, that's one example, but there's so many checkpoints that it's a really useful document. Okay, so that's the thingy. And then, so my piece of advice from experience is to involve your user. Okay, because there's always a feature. We were talking about feature earlier, going through the documentation. So going through the documentation is interesting. So it's going to give you an heads up about what's available, what's not available. But still, there's going to be always a little feature that you haven't caught. Maybe you're going to focus on, for instance, in an earlier example, on forecasting. You're going to analyze how is the forecasting dealt with. But then, when you involve your user, so typically in a sandbox, they're going to discover that on their daily ways of working, specific things that they were doing, so like working with tasks, for instance, that are not high in your priority, but for them, that's their day-to-day job. Say again? Five? Wow. So they need to feed you back this information. Okay. Right. 5 minutes. So we need to crack on. First of all, you need to take the upgrade, so the migration itself, seriously. So that's something which is new in the Salesforce world. In the past, we used to take for granted that moving from one release to the other was done behind your back by Salesforce. Moving to Lightning is not that simple. You need to consider all the options, so we've discussed it previously. This is the method that Salesforce proposed, and I'm reusing. So educate yourself, so that's the why. Conduct gap analysis, that's the when. And do this training, so that's fantastic training modules. Again, great resource from Salesforce. User perspective, admin perspective, and project manager perspective. So that's really the scope of this talk today. As I said earlier, you need to identify if you've got users who are more likely to move to Lightning versus some that need to stay in Classic. My recommendation is not to try to do too much at the same time. Okay? So don't over-engineer the project in itself. Try a like for like, okay? And then when you're in Lightning, consider how to improve it. Okay? Having said that, remember when we talk about feature gap versus improvement, don't hesitate to drop a couple of low-hanging fruit. Nice thing which are going to benefit to your user and help for adoption. Okay? So try to balance the project. Okay, another thing, so you need to go through a list. So what I recommend to do as well is to identify each object you've got on your solution and go through this list and iterate. So see, so you've got one-off things to do, like configure my domain, create the home page. And then, so page layout, they're inherited from a classic. Salesforce One Action and Compact Layout, they're inherited if you've already configured Salesforce One. Otherwise, you've got to do it. I recommend that you tune the object page. And for following item, so it may be more complicated, but typically, so the way to do it, so JavaScript button or URL acts to be replaced with actions. And a Visual Force, to summarize it, you need to restyle them with SLDS. That's there's more to say about Visual Force, but of course we don't have time. Okay. Again, testing sandbox, and then you need to iterate. And I kept for the end this again. That's a cool new tool provided by Salesforce who really helped the deployment. So that's an App Exchange, which is called the Lightning Adoption Tracker. It's telling you who's in the Classic, who's in Lightning. Okay, so if you switch to Lightning, this is giving you an eye onto your org in production and say who's cheating and using the switch to go back to Classic. Okay, so if it's happening, you need to ask yourself the question, why is it happening? And is there a problem that I need to fix? And so that's interesting. And in summer 17, so the next release, you will be able to lock, in fact, the switch. So if you deploy Lightning, you can prevent the user to go back to Classic if it's your policy. Okay. So I'm not quite sure if we got time for question, but still, that's the end of the talk. And if there's any question in the room, so I'm happy to listen. That's the end. Thank you. Any question? Yeah, Louise. So question for Louise. She was asking what was the biggest hurdle in the rollout we've done so far. So for me, it was underestimating the effort and not involving the user. So I was talking about a little annoyance that don't necessarily surface to the management, so admin or stakeholder. And you cannot just rely on what you know about the solution. You need to involve the user and get them on a proper UAT to validate that you tick all the boxes. Any other question? Looks like no. So thank you. And that's it. If you want to fill the survey, we've got a survey on the website. Thank you very much.